In today's Number Corner lesson, we will be completing a page from your Number Corner student book, so go grab that now if you don't have it already. Let's turn over the calendar markers to reveal today's date. Here is September 17, September 18, September 19th. Ooh, look, that's different. Here's September 20th. Let's examine these new ones for a moment. What do you notice? Before I show you September 21st, predict what today's marker will look like. Pause the video now and make an observation about the new markers or a prediction about what today's marker will be. Who guessed two scrolls, three heel bones, and one staff? Check out the changes that you see. What disappeared on September 19th? What was added? Why was that? What modern number does September 19th represent? Remember, we are using ancient Egyptian numerals to represent our calendar markers this month. A scroll is equal to 100. So two scrolls would equal how much? Yes, that's right. They'd equal 100 plus 100, which is 200. Awesome. Now let's add the ones. How many staffs do you see? I see three sets of three, which is a total of 9 staffs. So I'm adding 9 to 200. And these ancient Egyptian symbols on the September 19th marker represent what? The modern number 209. Let's look at September 20th. Two scrolls and two heel bones. We know from our chart that a scroll is 100 and a heel bone is 10. So two hundreds and two tens would be what? Did you see that? 220. That's right. Okay. And what about today's date? Or for my A cohort watching on Tuesday, yesterday's date? Two scrolls, three heel bones, and one staff. Here's our key. So we have two scrolls, which is 200s. Three heel bones is 10 plus 10 plus 10. And then we have one staff. So we could add these up, 200 plus 30 plus 1, to figure out our modern number. And September 21st's calendar marker is equivalent to 231. And we have shown that here in expanded form. Now let's tackle page 1 in our Number Corner books. We are comparing three numeration systems. The first number system is the base 10 pieces, which you're probably very familiar with from previous grades. The second is the modern numerals. And the third is the ancient Egyptian numerals we've been working with this month. So you are to write the modern numerals and the Egyptian numerals to match each set of base 10 pieces. Let's do the first one together. What base 10 pieces do you see? I see one rod that is 10. And 8 cube units that are ones. In expanded form, this would be 10 plus 8 equals 18. In ancient Egyptian numerals, what would that be? 110, or one heel bone, and then 8 staffs to represent 8 ones. Now you do the next two, and when you get to the bottom question, I really want you to think. How are our modern numbers like the ancient Egyptian numbers? How are they different? Which system would you rather use every day? Why? Some of you are going to notice that this page is similar to the next Number Corner page that we've already looked at before. If page 2 was hard for you on expanded form the first time you attempted it, I want you to revisit it after this lesson and see if you can write out those larger numbers in expanded form the way that we've been practicing. We are going to be sharing our answers when we get back to class, and I can't wait to see what you've done.